Hello and welcome to Platts' first European Gas and Power Watch, a monthly review of key market developments based on our wholesale price assessments and fundamental analysis. My name is Henry Edwards Evans and I work in Platts' power and gas reporting team here in London. For this first video, we're going to focus on the UK, where gas prices have been falling heavily, pulling down electricity prices and boosting gas-fired power generation economics. UK gas prices have been on a steady downtrend through the year, with the price of day-ahead gas averaging 39.5 pence a therm in June. This is the first time the monthly average has dipped below 40 pence a therm since May 2010, and represents a significant step down from 2013's 68 pence per therm average. Our first chart illustrates this. Sharp decline in day-ahead price this year set against seven consecutive months of falling end-user demand. Now let's take a closer look at market dynamics with the help of this chart. Above the central zero line is demand, consumption, exports and storage. Below the line is supply, domestic production and imports. Both have shrunk, resulting in a fall in day-ahead prices indicated by the white line. On the demand side, storage injection was at 23 million cubic metres per day in June, down from last June's 39 million cubic metres, with stock levels higher this year after a mild winter. UK gas storage facilities were already 72% full at the start of June, compared with 31% at the start of June 2013. By the end of June, this year's storage was 84% full. Exports to Belgium, which averaged 15 million cubic metres per day across June, were limited by a two-week maintenance outage on the interconnector. UK end-user consumption in June was down 4% year-on-year, reflecting reduced household consumption that was only partially offset by higher use in the gas sector. On the supply side, Norwegian flows averaged 41 million cubic metres per day in June, down 40% year on year. Norway was carrying out maintenance during June, but lower volumes were more a function of slack demand than any lack of availability. LNG imports of 39 million cubic metres were up from June 2013. Qatar is sending steady volumes to the UK, where it is part owner of the South Hook terminal. Although prices for LNG are higher in Asia, Qatar has surplus volumes and the UK is a good market in which to sink them. Now, what is the outlook for July? General supply and demand conditions for July look similar to those in June, although with the interconnector back from maintenance, exports to Belgium should increase month on month. LNG supplies to the UK might reduce if Japanese demand increases for summer air conditioning peak. Russian transit gas continued to cross Ukraine at normal rates in June, despite Russia suspending flows intended to supply Ukraine itself. Although unlikely, a worsening of the situation here could affect European supplies. Finally, lower UK spot gas prices encouraged a shift to gas-fired power generation in June, which could continue into July, with gas at 40% or higher in the fuel mix. We calculate the price at which generators will switch from coal to gas at 34 pence per therm. Weak demand and healthy supply could see the free fall in gas prices decline to break-even point for LNG exports to the US or 25 pence a therm. Turning to the electricity markets, day-ahead prices in the UK fell for the seventh consecutive month in June to the lowest monthly average since May 2010. This was coupled with year-on-year demand decline, which has been the case now for nine straight months. The benchmark UK day-ahead contract averaged just above £45 per megawatt hour. This is 6% below May's average and 18% down on June 2013. The lowest since May 2010. Now let's look closer at market dynamics with this chart, which shows indigenous generation by source, total end user demand, and a declining spot price. With demand down over 7% year on year, the striking takeaway here is the decline in coal-fired output, the light blue block in the middle of our chart, down 2.63 terawatt hours, or 35% in June. That's its lowest contribution since August 2009. The reduction is explained by declining profit margins and 1.2 gigawatts of closures by the end of Q1 2014. Gas-fired generation, meanwhile, has become more competitive, with gas prices falling at a faster rate than those for power or coal. Spark spreads rose to £7.48 per megawatt hour, while dark spreads for coal plant declined to £14.65 per megawatt hour. Meanwhile, renewables output was 19% lower this June than last, with reduced wind and hydro output only partially offset by higher biomass production. Year-on-year imports rose by 300 gigawatt hours in June, with the UK price premium over the Netherlands rising from €7 to €20 per megawatt hour. For France, the premium was down from €30 to €20 per megawatt hour. Looking ahead, the market is expected to be well supplied. The seasonal decline in wind production may support thermal generation, and weak NBP prices could support gas-fired power generation. To conclude, we are in a situation of historically low demand, with correspondingly low gas and power prices. Norwegian gas flows and coal-fired generation have borne the brunt of reductions in supply needs. In July, both markets look well supplied, with the only bullish factors being a lower contribution from wind farms and any unexpected interruption of Russian gas flow through Ukraine. That's it for now. Thanks for joining us, and look out for our next European Gas and Power Watch in August.